Hey, this is Deborah King, and I'm here with my race series for January. And I honestly am a little bit scared to put this out there, but when I started this journey of becoming an artist, I decided to let the Holy Spirit kind of guide what I'm going to paint and how I'm going to paint it and invite him into that process. And these paintings were an exploration for me of the subject of race, which is hard for me to kind of think about and talk about because I'm in rural Iowa and just a lot of white people and not a lot of differences among us. And so I really wanted to think about the subject of race as I look at our country and all the things that are happening and how race and politics, all these things are dividing us, and I wanted to understand. So I began this journey to think about and to pray about and to meditate on what is this race thing and how do I fit into the world on this subject. So the very first painting that I did on this subject is this one here, which is probably backward in this video because I'm recording it backwards, but it says human race, and the background is it's like a picture, it's like a zooming up and out on the earth and looking at the continent, and it's all in different shades of brown because we're all made out of dirt really, and we're made from the dust, and we're all just kind of different shades of brown. And so that's the background. And then on the front part here it says human. And in that twisty font, kind of looks like blood vessels or the things that are underneath the skin. And then here, this word race. And if you come up to the gallery, I want you to be able to touch it and feel it because it's got some texture in here that's really neat. I took my finger and I dipped it in red paint and just wrote this just like I'm writing it in blood, the word race. And it is raised. I didn't put glass on this so that you could come in and feel this. It's raised. It was a reminder to me that I'm connected to the human race. It's our bloodline. It's who we are. That's the life that we have. That's all the same. That's race here. And then, you know, the rest of this is this outward view, this macro view of the world. And then over here, this is connected to the paper with a thread. And the thread is in the shape, it's a red thread in the shape of a heartbeat. That reminds us that we have more in common than we have differences. So if you can, I'm going to zoom in here. See this red thread that kind of connects us here and connects it to this paper of this is like space. And here we are. We're all together with this heartbeat that connects us. So thinking about the human race and how really we're all connected and we're all one race. I was proud of my kids as we were talking about racism. My kids were like, what do you mean? We're all the human race. Isn't that what race is? And so hopefully we can all have that view that we're all brothers and sisters together on this planet. The second one that I did is also a really textural piece. And if you come up to the gallery, I want you to feel it and just really touch this piece. This is a palm print. And if you can see, this looks like a giant fingerprint. And it's really, it's done with ridges. It's actually an adhesive that I put on there, and it's in ridges, and you can just feel it like it's a gigantic thumbprint. And I put on there the different colors, the different skin colors are all kind of represented in here, and I put my own palm on this and painted around it to show this connection. We did some research as I was digging into this subject, and the ridges on our fingers are actually created in the womb. It's not just genetics. It has to do with gravity for how you're facing in the womb and how what the pressures are on your skin, to how it wrinkles and how it forms. It's really neat. That's why we each have a unique fingerprint, that we're all different, and yet we're all so much the same as well. So that's what this piece is about, and you have to come feel this and feel the texture and this connection to the rest of the world. This one up here is really bright and fun, and really, this one is more about the process than the final result. The first thing I did on this was divide up the canvas into different sections, and I filled the sections with all different patterns, different kinds of things that represent different parts of the world, different perspectives, And they're all, so it was all divided up. And then I took, and I took the primary colors, which make up all the other colors, and I painted over them in more sections to show that even if you're from the same, like, area perspective of the world, whatever color is over the top of that colors how you see and experience the world around you. So you can see this is blue, and this has got the red over it, which makes it purple, and this has the yellow over it, which makes it green. So the combination of those things form our culture and form our understanding of who we are and our place in the world. And so all these colors end up being different, even in the same sectors. There are different perspectives. Over the top, this is unity, and this is done in different skin tones. It was enlightening for me to mix that all of the skin tones are mixed with the same base. And you just add a little more yellow on this side. You could even add purple on this side. And you just add different things to those, that you start with the same thing and add just a little bit of this and a little of that to get to all the different colors in our skin tones. So this was a reminder and a picture of that what unity can look like, and that we're all diverse, and that all of our perspectives and our cultures are colored by our events around us. So that's the unity painting. This last painting in the series, I was kind of afraid to paint. It felt controversial, but I had a clear picture in my head. If there was ever a time where I felt like God was asking me to paint something, this would be the painting. Every time I thought about painting this, I felt like God's hand was on me saying, this piece is important. And I don't know why it's important, but it was important that I paint it. So I was just obedient to the Spirit to paint this. And I did my research. Let me show it to you. This one, this is this painting here. And I was researching some of the protests about race. And I was looking at the graffiti and just trying to really see where are these people coming from? Because I don't have the same background and I don't understand why they're doing what they're doing, and where are they coming from? And I looked at all the graffiti and tried to look past the bad words, tried to look past to really see what their hearts were saying. And there was a common themes throughout the graffiti. And so I wrote those common themes down on this wall. This is a picture of a young man who is carrying all of these negative feelings with him in his heart, and he does not have a place to express those. And so he's under the underpass spray painting all of his hurt onto the walls. And so you can see in the painting here some of the words, and they'll be backwards for you, but loneliness and fear and anger and hear me and abuse and trauma and slavery and all of these things, poverty, that the people that are doing the graffiti here, some of them are living under these underpasses. This is how they're feeling, and this is the hurt underneath some of the rage that we've seen. And so I painted, this is the image in my head when I first decided to go on this art journey with God. I saw this picture so clearly in my head when I asked, what is my purpose in doing this? What do you want me to do? And it was this picture of two heads together. And so I painted it here into this piece. And it's Jesus meeting this young man where he's at in the middle of his pain, and telling him that he is loved and that he matters, that Jesus knows his name, and that Jesus cares about what he's feeling and where he's at and all the injustices and the things that are going on. That Jesus meets us in the middle of our mess, in the middle of our brokenness, that God is there to meet us in that place that's messy. And so that is the picture that I saw in my head that God told me to paint that was important. And so I've put it out here for you guys. Hope you have a chance to come look at it. It's one of my bigger pieces. And it was hard to paint, but I put it out there for you. So that is my race series. It was just a small little series for January. And I think it's not really meant to be a political statement at all. It's not meant to be that I'm siding with one side or the other of anything. I think it's this piece is a call to compassion, to look past all of the negative things that are happening and all the violence, and to look into people's hearts and say, why are you so afraid? What is it underneath this? And what's going on in your heart and in your mind that God needs to heal, that we can help each other with, that we can help each other see? And I hope that we can look into each other's hearts during this time when it's such turmoil. I put a couple other pieces in this, which are part of my Lily series. The Lily series is something that I did as I was camping and looking into a dirty pond and seeing the mess, and trying to remember to be a fragrance in the middle of the mess and to lift my head up above all of it and be able to be something beautiful in the middle of that. So this is part of that series. This is Purple Fragrance, and it's one of those lilies in the middle of the pond. This is a 16 by 20, and it has all the little fireflies. It's just a really calming piece, a reminder to be that sense of calm and peace and beauty in the middle of chaos. This was the first piece in that series. You can see some of this messiness in the background of the pond, and then the fragrance and the lilies that are in the middle of that. This is a fun series that I've sold more paintings out of than I could produce. As soon as I made one, it would sell. And so these are the two that are my recent ones that I'm putting out there for you. The last one that I put up is just a little winter scene. It's called Dusk Bunnies, because there's two little rabbits hiding in here. This is the view from my window on a winter's day, and it's just a watercolor, which is different for me, and I would put that out with my winter series. These are some of the other pieces from my winter series. So that's what I'm doing recently and what I'm up to, and I wanted to put this out there for you. Hope you had a good Christmas and you're looking into the new year with hope, and with eyes to see what the things that God's doing. We'll talk to you later. Oh, let me show you this is my comment book. If you're up here, if you come to see this, please write to me and tell me what you thought of the series and what pieces spoke to you. Here's my business card. Thanks for joining me, and I will see you next time.